Happy New Year to all the viewers. Today, 1st January 2019, Atheist Center Vijayawada, India has launched an YouTube channel, Positive Atheism. Atheism is a way of life, free from sentiments, superstitions, and beliefs. In this channel, you'll get to know more about atheistic philosophy, atheism and education, atheism and social work, atheism and politics, atheism and economics, and atheism and values. Atheism can change your perspective of thinking and make you a better person.
I am privileged to share the book Positive Atheism, authored by Gora. Gora made it very clear that any idea or action need to change according to the need of the people, and the concept of positive atheism we are discussing today is from the first chapter, Theism and Atheism, from Positive Atheism book. Theism and atheism express man's attitude to the world around him. Primitive man's world consists of forces like wind, rain, sun, moon, diseases, and death. He couldn't understand these things and developed fear for his existence. As an individual, he could not face these forces. And so he started gathering people together, and so they formed into clans, families, and tribes, and so on. The formation of social structures increased their awareness of their needs, and so customs and morality were developed. The primitive man was dominated by the nature, and the modern man today is dominated by political, economical, and technical developments. The man reacts to his surroundings with his skills, imagination, and intelligence. His feelings of fear, hope, love, greed, and hate changes the reaction to his surroundings. The factors of environment in turn discipline and influence man's way of understanding. Man always reacts to his surroundings positively or negatively, and his reaction is of two kinds. The first one is he surrenders himself to the forces and drifts along with the happenings around him. The second one is he asserts himself upon the surroundings and harnesses the factors to satisfy his own needs. By surrendering himself, he is becoming a slave. This is seen in theistic way of life. By asserting himself, he develops freedom. He is free to think and act, and this is a theistic way of life. Primitive man was insecure due to lack of knowledge, and so he became timid and submissive. His method of understanding his surroundings was very simple. He imagined a man like God who controlled the whole world. That God was a man reflects man's domination. That faith in God by primitive man was useful for him. It gave him a sense of security and satisfied his curiosity. He thought that all the happenings around him are creation of God. So he surrendered himself to God and developed a slave mind. As God was man-like, the primitive man attributed the human qualities of righteousness, love, mercy, curses, anger to the God. Then he developed moral conduct in social groups. When he was in trouble, he thought of the love and mercy of God that gave him hope. Man is basically an aesthetic person. So in worshipping God, he used songs and dance in the rituals. So the concept of God answered several needs of a primitive man. So his journey with God continued. Man fancied the existence of soul as a detachable part of the body. Dreams are supposed to be souls of rambles in a strange land while man is asleep. Death is the permanent escape of soul from the body. So to dispel the fear of death, man imagined heaven and hell and also rebirth. Religion basis is on the existence of God, soul, and faith. And the essence of religion is man's surrender to God. So the attitude of surrender is theism. Religion was the early phase of the attitude of surrender. Surrender released man from the sense of responsibility and afforded him the security and tranquility of a caged bird. Within the safe religious belief, these started thinking and questioning and become rational. This led to logic and analyzing and inquiry. Consequently, the concept of God gradually changed from primitive fetish to a metaphysical notion of being and becoming. The noisy ritual, blood sacrifices, and ancestral worship of religious belief was replaced slowly by the silent meditation of later centuries. However, the intellectual understanding of religion was God, soul, heaven, hell, rebirth are intangible. They were imaginary and not perceptible to sight, sound, taste, smell, or touch. So further change in religion was seen in as a shift from visionary spiritualism to a concrete materialism. So man needs to think about his understanding of surroundings and his reaction to the happenings. Today's man asserts himself in getting his needs satisfied, but surrenders himself mentally to God. So by deed, man is an atheist, and by thought, a theist.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.